I'm going to do in this video is show you how to deal with something that's broken on your WordPress website. This can be typically when the entire site becomes unresponsive in some way. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to show you how it's broken. So if I click on the contact page, for example, you see nothing appears here. I'll just go back out and pick, say, services. So you can see none of these links are actually working. The pages behind them seem to be broken. Now, what we could do is we could go to WP Admin, but this seems to be broken as well. So whatever's caused this has stopped us getting in and disabling the plugins. So what we need to do now is we need to access them by FTP. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to connect to FTP and go to WP content. So I've opened that up here. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to look for the plugins directory. And there it is there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to right click it and choose rename. And I'm going to rename it to plugins-broken. I'm going to go back out and I'm going to refresh the page. And I can see from that the plugins were the cause, because by removing all the plugins, which is what I effectively did by renaming the directory, I fixed the site. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to show you by going back to the contact page and doing a refresh. So you can see the plugins were the cause, and I've disabled them all. So for example, you can see here now, you can see the code for my contact form. That's appearing rather than the contact form now, because I actually disabled all of those plugins. So now what we need to do is we need to re-enable all the plugins one by one. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go in here to FTP again, and I'm going to choose create directory, and I'm going to call this directory plugins. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the plugins-broken, and I'm going to one by one move them into the plugins directory. The first one I'm going to choose is contact form 7. I'm just going to drag that over, and now I'm going to switch back to the website and I'm just going to refresh. So you can see I've enabled the contact form 7 by moving it back now, and that contact form is now appearing. But also you can see that the site is still working, so it wasn't that plugin that was the problem. So next I'm going to take Akismet and I'm going to move that in, and I'm going to refresh the site again, and you can see the site is still working, so that wasn't the problem. So now I'm going to take the all-in-one SEO pack, I'm going to move that in and refresh again, and it's still working. So literally what I'm going to keep doing is I'm going to keep going one by one until the site stops working. And the site has now stopped working. So I can see that the problem here is the backup WordPress plugin, which is the last one I moved in. And that one is obviously broken in some way. So I'm going to move that back into the plugins-broken just to confirm again and do a refresh. So that does seem to be the problem plugin. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go into plugins-broken. I'm going to select everything except for the backup WordPress plugin. And by the way, the way I do that is if I do Control A, pick everything, and then I just hold down the Control key and click that one, it deselects it and leaves everything else selected. It's just a nice little quick tip for selecting lots of stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move all of these other plugins back into the plugins folder, leaving the backup WordPress plugin where it is. And now I'm going to refresh again and see if there are any other problems. The site is still working perfectly. What I just showed you applies to themes as well. If your theme is broken, what you can do is you can rename the theme. So I'm running on Thesis 1.5 here. So I'm just going to rename that to 1.5-broken. So you can see the site won't load now. What I have to do then is I need to log in, and you can still log in with WP Admin. And what I need to do is log in and change the theme. So by going down the admin dashboard to themes, and choosing, for example, the default 2010 theme. And then what I'd need to do is figure out what the problem was with the original theme. That's how you start to debug problems and fix problems with your WordPress plugins and themes. Thanks for watching.